to St. Patrick's Cathedral for the next in the current series of recitals on the Willis Organ by Mr. David Lee, the organist and assistant master of music. The aim of this series is that in these stressful times, listeners, particularly those who are ill or who are forced to isolate, might find a spiritual dimension in music, as well as the enjoyment it brings. Today's programme, which features the works of four composers, focuses on the liturgical season of Epiphany, when we think of the visit of the far-travelling magi, or wise men, to worship the baby Jesus. That mystic journey is captured in the first work we are about to hear, Epiphany, by the French organist composer Gaston Lattès, 1909 to 1991. Although blinded shortly after birth, his disability did not prevent him from having a long and productive life. Among his teachers at the Paris Conservatoire were Marcel Dupré and Louis Vierne. Lattès was extremely influential within French organ culture, and indeed Olivier Latre, the organist of Notre Dame, once indicated that it was Lattès who most inspired him to seek a career as an organist. Gaston Lattès' vibrant Epiphany was composed in 1984. The imagery behind the work is the arrival of the Magi at Christ's Nativity. The music is full of joy, excitement, and a sense of wonder, which complements the biblical story presented in St. Matthew's Gospel. Epiphany by Gaston Lattès.
Thank you.
1630s and 1707 is regarded as one of the greatest organists and composers prior to J.S. Bach. In fact, Bach is believed to have walked some 250 miles to hear Buxtehude who had played the organ. It's little wonder, therefore, that Bach's music bears major influences of Buxtehude. The star which guided the wise men on their journey to the infant Jesus inspired the chorale Wie schön leuchtet der Morgenstern, how beautifully shines the morning star, which caught the imagination of many composers. Buxtehude's setting of the chorale is as a chorale fantasia, a large-scale virtuosic work. The first two parts show the chorale melody in a relatively simple setting, first in the bass, then in the soprano voice. The music grows quickly more complex after that, with first a fantasia and then a fugue based on the chorale melody. The last rhapsodic section is a brilliant finale with rapid notes, and in the last four bars, even the pedals join the fun. Wie schön leuchtet der Morgenstern by Dietrich Buxtehude. The Great Prelude and Fugue in C Major, BWV 547, is an organ piece composed by J.S. Bach in Leipzig, presumably in the year 1738 to 1742. There are several interesting features to this work. For one thing, it is almost as if Bach experiments with movement and motionlessness. The 9/8 time signature of the prelude almost automatically evokes a rocking motion, not unlike that of a procession, and is sometimes reckoned to symbolize the trudging along of the wise men on their journey to Bethlehem. This is a work which is often performed around this time of year due to its thematic connections to several other choral and instrumental works of this season. For example, Bach's Pastoral in F, BWV 590, and the canonic variations upon From Heaven on High the Angels Came, BWV 769, some of which have hints in the fugue. Bach also used the theme in Cantata BWV 65. Moreover, in the pedal, almost like an ostinato bass, appears a fanfare formed by descending notes as if to symbolize the descent of Christ on the earth. The fugue is an amazing work of genius in that its subject or theme is stated over 50 times in a tour de force of creative and constantly varied counterpoint, which is always at the highest level of inspired beauty. The Prelude and Fugue in C, BWV 547, by J.S. Bach.
Thank you.
music of Max Reger, 1873 to 1916, has a special place in organ repertoire, and indeed he is regarded by many as the greatest German composer for the pipe organ since J.S. Bach. He lived during an era which can justifiably be called the Second Age of Enlightenment, a time when scientific discoveries greatly influenced the popular mindset, and the word revolution defined the era, be it scientific, socio-economic, psychological, political, or technological. It is important to understand that Reger did not see himself as being revolutionary against composers like Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms, all of whom he greatly admired, but rather wishing to work towards a further development of their styles. At the end of the 19th century, Reger experienced a great personal crisis that he was only able to overcome through composing copiously. His fantasia on the chorale, Wie schön leuchtet der Morgenstern, how beautifully shines the morning star, is one of his principal and most significant works from that period, in which he displays various forms of compositional freedom. This work is certainly a testament to the virtuosity and compositional diversity of Max Reger. The fantasia on the chorale, Wie schön leuchtet der Morgenstern, by Max Reger.
Thank you.
of the Fantasia on the Chorale Die Schönen Leuchter der Morgenstern by Max Richter brings today's recital to a close. We offer Mr. Lee our deepest thanks for his superb playing in this program of music, which, as you can appreciate, makes enormous demands on the performer. So very well done indeed to David, and our sincere thanks to him. Thanks also to you for listening in. I do hope that you'll keep in touch and join us again for the next recital. Until the next time, please take care and keep safe and well.